In a previous tutorial video, we covered how to create motion tweens in Animate CC. Make sure you've watched that video before you do this one, because this depends on you knowing motion tweens before you can actually start animating multiple properties on a motion tween. So the name motion tween implies that the only kind of animation that you can do is motion, so moving left to right, top to bottom, or diagonally. This is absolutely not true. Motion tween can do motion, but it can also animate a lot of different things such as rotation, the scale, it can add a glow, a drop shadow, change the color. There are a lot of different properties that you can animate with a motion tween, and you can in fact animate an object's multiple properties. So it can both go left to right, change the scale, rotate, and change colors all simultaneously. So let's see how this works. Working from the previous example from the motion tween video, we have three stars that are moving across the stage. I have staggered all three stars so that we can focus on one at a time. Each of these lengths of animation is only 1 second long because each of these are 24 frames and my frame rate is 24 frames per second. 1 second worth of animation is really hard to see. So you have a couple of options with this. I'm going to go ahead and change my size to normal. For each of these, you can lengthen the amount of time, and then you can highlight and move this one over and lengthen the amount of time this one lasts. And same thing, I can highlight this one and move it down and lengthen how long this lasts. Or you could change the frame rate by clicking on the pasteboard and changing the frame rate here and going slower. With the frame rate change, it's going to make it really, really choppy. So by increasing instead the motion tween length, this is going to be really smooth animation, but it's going to be a lot slower so we can see it. So now working with this particular first star, the yellow star, it looks like a normal, regular star that we see. We can animate multiple properties, not just motion. This one has a motion path that's a little bit curved, but let's say we also want to scale it. So this first keyframe, if I click on the object, it's 119 by 121 width and height. If I move my playhead over to the very last keyframe of that layer, then I can click on my object again and make it a lot smaller. And if it goes onto my stage, I can drag it out just a little bit more. And what this is gonna do is it's gonna make it animate from a large star on the first keyframe of that animation to a small star on the last keyframe. So if I scrub that through, it goes from a big star to a little star. Now the cool thing about this is I could actually move my playhead anywhere in that motion tween, and I can change those properties midway. So let's say I want it to go from big to little to big. Let's click on it again. Notice that each time I have to move the playhead and then click on the object again and change the properties for that object. Now, as I do this, this motion path is getting a little bit weird, but that's okay. We're going to go ahead and see what happens. So as we scrub this, it goes from big to little to big to little. So we can see the black dots indicating keyframes or changes in properties at each of these different points in time. So I can scrub that back through and let's go ahead and try a different one. Not just working with the width and height, we can also do something called effects. So let me lock the first layer and unlock this one to make sure that I'm targeting exactly what I intend to target. So right now this star is pink. If I go to color effect, I can actually change the brightness so it can get brighter and duller and brighter and duller, however I want it to look. I can change the tint, which is the color, and I can even change the alpha, which is going to make it fade in, fade out. So let's try tint for this particular one. So tint right now, the style is pink, and it's right now at a 25% tint. So it doesn't look like it's 25% because the color of it is actually pink in the first place. So let's say by this point in time, I want it to be zero tint because I like it to have the original color. And maybe halfway through that pyramid, I'll click on the object. And I want it to be, let's do blue. And it's not going to show anything because I need to make this 100%. So maybe by the peak of the pyramid, I want it to be red. So I'm going to choose red. And by halfway through again, I'll click and do kind of a purple color. And by the last keyframe in that motion tween, I'll change this to an orange. Okay. So again, every time we change properties, we see these property keyframes that indicate that there's some change at those points in time. So as I go through now, that star goes from pink to blue to red to purple and then finally to orange. All right. So last but not least is the rotation, and we'll also do something called a filter. So let's lock down that first or that second star and unlock the third star. Click on this object and we're going to go over here and we're going to change a filter. So there are a bunch of filters and these are only available when you have a movie clip symbol. You can add a drop shadow, you can make it blurry, you can make it glow. And these are fun to really play with, especially some of these gradient glows and these gradient bevels. But I'll just do blur for right now because it's the easiest one to see. So as you can see, it got a little bit fuzzy. And I can say 0 for both of those, so it's totally perfectly clear on my first keyframe. Then I can move down in time, and I want to make it really blurry about halfway through. So again, I'll click on the object, and I'm going to bump up the blur so it gets really blurry. And then by this point in time, maybe I want it to go back to perfectly clear. So if we scrub this, we can see it goes from clear to blurry, and it's going to go back from blurry to clear. So if I click on this object, notice that there's nothing in here about rotation. Again, we can change the properties. We can even change the color effect. We can change the width and height. You saw that we could change the X and Y coordinates or the motion. You could either do it here or just by physically dragging. But then how do we change the rotation? The rotation's a little bit weird of a property because it's not tied actually to the object, it's tied to the motion tween. So you have to actually click on the tween in order to get the rotation options. So you can rotate a certain amount of times, and then you can also do additional rotation, and then you can choose if it goes clockwise or counterclockwise, so it's up to you. So for this particular object, by the time it gets to the end of the motion tween, I want it to have rotated. Let's go ahead and click at the end of the motion tween. I always get that confused. I don't get it confused, but I just always forget. So if you forget, don't worry about it. Just remember you got to click on the motion tween. So let's say I want it to rotate, you know, just 2 times. And then I'm going to scoot it back, and you can see it sort of rotates and moves as it moves along. And the longer your animation is, the more you're going to see of this. If I had chosen to rotate it like 85 times, it would go so fast that you might not even be able to see it. So this really depends on how long the actual tween lasts in your animation. So let's go ahead and see what this looks like for right now. So that one gets bigger and smaller. This one changes color. And then this one has that blur as well as some of that rotation. So you can do a lot of those property changes, and I encourage you to play with all those different filters and these different color effects. The last thing I wanted to show you is that you can actually add multiple things to an object, including text. So if I wanted to add some text in here, and I wanted to call this, I just need to unlock it, I always forget. So let's call this Star Fall. And we can choose what color it should be. I'm going to make it white. And I'm going to type in here like 250. So it's massive. And that might be a little bit too massive. Too ambitious. Okay. So let's say I want this to actually fade in and scale in and do all kinds of other different stuff. Well, first thing, I got to go ahead and convert this to a symbol. So MC title. And then I want to change certain properties. So when it starts, I'm going to change the alpha to be 0%. That means it's totally faded out. And by the end of it, oops, I need to change the add an animation, insert motion tween. By the end of that animation, I want it to actually be 100%. That means it's going to fade in. Okay, then let's go back here. click on our object, and then we can go ahead and scale that down and kind of recenter it. And then we might need to change the width and height again. So sometimes you have to change both properties because it acts weird. Okay, so there it's going to fade in and get bigger. And then you can actually start adding other kind of stuff. So if I wanted to add more time to this animation, so let's say I want it to last as long as all this, I can click here and hit F5 or insert timeline frame just so it lasts longer. And this is where I can start changing maybe the color or the tint, or I can add a gradient glow, which is one of my favorite things to do. So I can say by here, this object, let's go ahead and add a gradient glow. And I want the gradient, let's see, color stop. I want to choose a green. And I know you can't see this, but there are these little things at the bottom that allow you to change the color. And you can choose what type. So I can do an inner gradient, and then I can change the colors for each one of these. So it's going to fade in. And then by this point, maybe I want that inner gradient, that final color, to be a green. So it's going to change from orange to green. And then maybe here I can have it change to another color. So it's just kind of playing around. But you can add multiple tweens. You can scale it. You can fade it. You can change the gradient color. You can move it. You can do all those different things in a motion tween. So don't think you just have to do motion when you're doing a motion tween.